Paul Worrell was a local boxing celebrity, a bantamweight champion and winner of countless trophies. He'd been arrested after a brawl in a pub, and the Crown Court decided that he should be sent to a mental hospital, as he was probably suffering from schizophrenia and had a history of suicide attempts. Although a bed was offered in Guy's Hospital, the authorities judged him too violent for an open ward, and he was returned to Brixton Prison, where he spent a total of 4 months, often in solitary confinement. On January the 12th, he was found dead in his cell. He had apparently hanged himself. Paul and his girlfriend had a six-month-old baby boy, and his family don't accept he could have killed himself.
The last time I took the baby to see Paul, and I was leaving, I told him I was going to have the baby for the week. And he said to me, that's good, mummy. Look after the baby for me. And as soon as I get well and get out here, I pay you back everything that you spend on that baby. And that's something worth to live for. I don't think Paul would commit suicide. Not Paul at all.
The jury at the coroner's inquest did not return a verdict of suicide, but an open verdict. Local MP John Cartwright has called for a full inquiry.
Two things worry me. Firstly, that the medical authorities at Brixton Prison felt he was fit to plead against the charge, whereas two independent consultants both said that he was a schizophrenic who urgently needed medical treatment. I think the prison stopped him getting that medical treatment. Secondly, given that he had a record of mental illness, given that he had a record of attempted suicide, I am puzzled as to know how he could have succeeded in committing suicide in prison, where he should have been watched every minute of the day.
Friends and relatives of the dead man have set up a campaign and plan a protest march to Brixton Prison next month. This is Jane Corbin in Plumstead. What would you like to see done now?
I think it's absolutely essential that we have a full public inquiry to establish, first of all, why he was in prison, and to establish, secondly, more importantly, how he came to commit suicide. Given that he was young and black, I think it's absolutely important that justice is seen to be done, and that's not the situation at the moment.
Friends and relatives of the dead man have set up a campaign and plan a protest march to Brixton Prison next month. This is Jane Corbin reporting.